an opioid disorder. So we compared different brain areas and people who had an opioid disorder and people who were healthy control. Basically what we found is that there were significant differences in blood flow in three areas, which were the limbic system, the basal ganglia, and the cerebellum. Pretty much what we found is that this is consistent with what was seen in the presentation of individuals with this disorder. Pretty much the reward system, some memory issues, and then psychomotor problems. I think this is an important topic to go to jump more research in, just because of the opioid crisis that's going on right now. We want to find out more about what's going on in the brain itself and how that translates into neuropsychological deficits.